The 1980s, Sean Young, and dinosaurs. What could possibly go wrong? This time, we're revisiting that crazy, wonderful, magical day-glow era we know as the 1980s. Specifically, an odd little movie which still has a following today that features somewhat believable dinosaurs almost a decade before Jurassic Park. I'm talking about Baby, Secret of the Lost Legend from 1985. Baby was made by Touchstone Pictures, an offshoot of Disney. The idea was to use Touchstone to make movies for a broader audience and might explore more grown-up themes. The thinking was a lot of people would avoid a Disney movie since they figured it was just for kids. With Touchstone, Disney could get around that and make more mainstream movies, some of which were PG-13 or even R-rated. In fact, in this movie, people get killed, and the native tribe includes women who are topless, because that's how some native tribes in Africa do things. Disney never should have shuttered Touchstone. That was a mistake. But I digress. Here we have a somewhat family-friendly movie about a researcher and her husband trying to save a baby dinosaur from an unscrupulous scientist. It all starts like this. Said scientist straight up murks a guy in the opening act and steals his research about dinosaurs living in the African jungle. He wants the discovery for himself, you see, and sets out to capture the dinosaurs. Meanwhile, one of his grad students is unhappy that she isn't finding any good dinosaur bones on this dig. Her husband wants to go home, but then she's convinced to travel into the jungle and solve a mystery. A local tribe has found and eaten some meat, which has made them all sick, and she deduces that this meat may have come from a dinosaur. So she and her husband go in search of the creature. Not surprisingly, they find some. Brontosauruses, in fact. After meeting and, thanks to Polaroid, making friends with a native tribe, the pair find a mom and dad dinosaur and a baby one, which they name Baby. As they try to study these behemoths and make friends with the baby dinosaur, the bad guy comes and captures the mom. And he wants the baby, too. What follows is a running chase to keep ahead of Professor Bad Guy and keep Baby safe. Baby is, in a way, a kind of metaphor for this couple. The husband wants kids, the wife not so much. Here, they have to take care of a baby, albeit a baby dinosaur, and face the challenges that come with taking care of something so young and needing constant attention. Baby even interrupts them when they're trying to have makeouts. Tell me that's not like real life, huh? Anyway, this isn't a slapstick comedy, but there are some fun moments. It's a surprisingly grown-up story, and you see people getting killed, which Disney generally didn't do. Unless it was Bambi's mom. But all is not perfect in this movie. In the days before CGI, filmmakers had to rely on stop motion, miniatures, models, animatronics and puppetry to make fantastic creatures like aliens and dinosaurs. Operators ran elements of the creatures from both outside as well as inside the creature. That's how they did The Thing, Jabba the Hutt, and stuff like that. That's how it was done in Baby, too, with two operators inside the baby dinosaur costume, plus cables to move the face. In a lot of ways, those things still look better than CGI, but Maybe not so much in the case of this movie. The dinosaurs look okay for the most part, but usually only in long shots. Close-ups are where the things really start to fall down with Baby. The filmmakers opted to give the dinosaurs human facial expressions, which the animatronics just couldn't convincingly replicate. Plus, they cry and have other human traits, which kind of falls flat here. And does this face look familiar? Asking for a friend. Anyway, the cartoon dragon is animated, which gives it a much more convincing range of facial expression than Baby or its parents have. The dinosaurs here look best when seen crashing through huts and the jungle and stuff. They did a good job with that. In other shots, it's painfully obvious the adult dinosaurs were suspended on wires. You can tell because they kind of bounce in a weightless way when they walk in some of the shots. But overall, at least in the long shots, these are pretty good dinosaurs for the era this movie came from. For me, it's the cast that makes this movie work in the parts that work. Sean Young is quite good as the grad student trying to make a find on this dig. William Katt, the greatest American hero himself, is also very good as the husband, really liked him, and they have a great chemistry together. You may also recognize this guy, not from his role here as a doctor treating the sick natives, but from this role as a doctor he took just a few years later after this movie. That's right, Edward Hardwick, who played Dr. Watson in the Granada Sherlock Holmes television series. Still the best iteration of Holmes for my money. And Julian Fellowes, a stalwart in British television, both in front of and behind the camera, rounds things out as Professor Bad Guy's assistant. Best of all, and the actor who steals the whole thing, if you ask me, is our old friend Patrick McGoohan from The Prisoner as Professor Bad Guy. We saw him in The Phantom and again in Ice Station Zebra. While we don't see his explosive side in this one, McGoohan really brings the quiet menace here. Just look at that face. I wouldn't want to mess with him. Would you? He has some great scenes here, believe it or not. Now, McGoohan was no fool, and I'm pretty certain he knew this movie wasn't exactly Shakespeare or anything, but the man just gives it 110% anyway. Damn fine actor, Patrick McGoohan. Critics savaged this one, but I think McGoohan still comes off looking great. So, is Baby any good? Well, yeah, I think so. I'm giving this one 2 paws up. It could have been better. It can be a little sappy. The reveal of the dinosaurs is kind of a letdown. There's no sense of awe or wonder when we first see one, and the movie really needed that. But it does have some fun things, and it has that 80s feel, and it doesn't look slapped together. The natives are treated respectfully, and Katt, Young, and McGoohan are really what make this movie worth your time. Baby, Secret of the Lost Legend is available on VHS, DVD, Blu-ray, and digitally from Amazon Prime. You can watch my review of The Phantom here. And down here, there's some other movie reviews you can check out. You take care of yourselves, and I'll see you in the next one.